here's something I like to do when I'm reading the comments. I like to not give a fuck. Not cute. An outfit is so off-putting. Anytime you go into someone's comments and you see someone comment something so evil, you have to understand that they are simply just projecting their own beliefs onto you. In this video, I'm gonna teach you how to not let these bozos get the best of you. Saying, oh, I'm just not gonna read the comment section, that's unrealistic. Would you really wanna go to the lens of ignoring all of the people telling you something positive in your comments just because you're afraid you might see someone that's saying something negative? Here's something I like to do when I'm reading the comments. I like to not give a fuck. I get that you may see a lot of people online. Their content is very like, know who you are. You are everything. Stop worrying about what other people are saying. And I know when you're coming from a place of possibly insecurity or uncertainty about yourself, that can sound very hard to grasp. You're kind of like, oh my God, have these people just always been this confident? But you know, the only difference between people like me who are confident is that we're just choosing to not make the internet's opinions and other people's opinions mean something about us. I get all types of crazy comments. I literally got a comment that said, she's not that hot. I decided to pin the comment because I'm a smart ass. I put it to the top of the comments and I said, let's see what happens. Let's see if anyone disagrees. There were like 600 people who hearted that comment. I could have taken that comment and that heart, all those hearts from those people, and thought, oh my God, that means that 600 people think I'm ugly. But instead, I just chose to reframe it and like, okay, that means 600 people think I'm hot, but maybe just not that hot because they're just disagreeing with what I'm saying. It's really all in the way that you choose to frame the situation. You cannot make hate comments mean something about you. If anything, it should mean something about that person. Anytime somebody comments something negative on your post, you need to take a moment to say, what does that say about them? Anytime you go into someone's comments and you see someone comment something so evil, so mean, so nasty, you have to understand that they are simply just projecting their own beliefs onto you. I post content about being an influencer, about making money online, about doing things that make you feel happy. Someone may come and comment something like, this is unrealistic, this cannot be a career. Do you think I'm going to take that comment and then make it my reality and think, now I can never be an influencer? Now I can never do what fulfills me because some random person told me that I can't do it. Absolutely not. You need to learn how to remain confident. You need to remember that just because somebody comments something or a bunch of people comment something doesn't mean you have to make it actually mean something about yourself. This is the internet, honey. You need to not take the internet so seriously. These people don't know you. The people that are hating on you, the people that are saying all these things, you don't even know them. So why are you taking the comment of some random 50-year-old man in Wisconsin seriously when that literally has nothing to do with your fashion content, with your makeup content? What? Who is that? Like, do you know what I mean? Like, you could just choose to believe this man's clearly crazy and obsessed with me because not only did he have negative thoughts about me, but he went out of his way to comment them so I could see them. If that's not obsession, then I don't know what is. Because let's be real, we're all messy. We all have our own thoughts. We all will scroll on TikTok or Instagram and see something to be like, oh, she look a mess. But you know what I won't do? Comment it. Because if I comment, she looks a mess, that means way more about me and my need to bring down others to make myself feel good than it does about her. She felt competent enough to post something about the way she looks. She felt competent enough to put herself out there. You felt so insecure that you had to go into the comments and try to tear her down for being sure of herself, for being certain. So you need to remember that anybody that is in your comments trying to be a hater is clearly insecure because confident people never feel the need to do. You notice you never see sexy, confident, rich people in the comments like hating. Have you ever noticed that? There's a reason for that. Because when you're too busy worried about your own fulfillment and minding your own business and spreading positivity and love, you don't have time to be in people's comments hating and trying to tear them down. And honestly, it just makes you a loser. Don't let some stranger's opinion on the internet or in person for that matter make you stray from that, because if they felt the need to go out of their way to try to tear you down, then that means they're already intimidated by you. I think something that I do, now this one is to be taken with a grain of salt because, like I said, you know, if you're already feeling insecure, it's gonna probably give you an extra little ego hit. But when I see like crazy comments sometimes in my posts, I just like to pin them. Like, I've literally had some of my followers see me pin a crazy comment or a mean comment or something, and they'll be like, pin of shame. And I kind of like that. Like, that's the thing. It's like, it's very classy. Like, you don't even need to really say anything back. You just need to kind of pin it to the top so that people can see that. So one, that the commenter can be shamed. So if they have any remorse for what they commented, they might just delete the comment, which has happened. They have no remorse and they're standing 10 toes down in it even after they got the notification that I pinned it to the top. Now they will just have to deal with people arguing with them in the comments. And maybe those people will make them realize something about themselves or not. Maybe they'll just continue being a hater. And who am I to get in the way of their passion for hating on people? Hence why I'd like to highlight the comments. A lot of other influencers actually like to do response videos to hate comments and negative comments. You always see those videos on TikTok where it's like a stitch of like a comment that somebody left talking about them, the way they look or something they did, and then they're giving like some sort of clap back. Now, me personally, I feel like it just doesn't give that. Like, if it's something relevant and you can use it to make like a further point, so be it. But like, there's just certain comments that are so blatantly stupid that you really shouldn't be wasting your breath, time, and energy on. If somebody just says she's ugly, you don't need to make a whole response video to that. Like, that's not necessary. Now, if it's something that's truly attacking your character and something you feel very strongly about, okay, maybe you can, but make sure the video that you make or the comment that you comment back to that person is something that you are not going to regret posting 2 months from now, 6 months from now, a year from now. If it's something that you're like, am I going to be like, I didn't really need to say that? Go ahead and keep it in your head, baby. Because if you spend all your time trying to clap back at everybody that ever says something negative or nasty or hateful to you, you're going to be so tired. You'd literally have to argue with people every day. We don't have the time to be arguing in the comments with haters. They're clearly sad and insecure. Why are you stooping to their level? It's not that serious. Ignore it or pin it to the top and let the audience do their work. Let life happen. Let fate take its course. You don't have time for that. You're about your business. You got things to do. You have a life to be living. You have happiness to chase, fulfillment to seek. You don't have time to be responding to everybody. So don't do that unless you want to and you feel like in the future, a year from now, you're gonna see that video and be like, you know what, I ate that and I don't feel any remorse about that and I didn't say anything that might get me canceled, I didn't say anything crazy, then so be it. But that's just my two cents on that. I also think too, if you're having one of those days where you just feel like the internet is just coming down on you, like they are just saying all types of crazy stuff, or you've had a few videos back to back in the last week or so that have just been taken really negatively by the internet, don't be afraid to just take a self-care day. There's nothing wrong with just being like, okay, I'm not gonna make content today. I'm just feeling a little down. I'm feeling like, I don't know, like people aren't viewing my stuff. People are not responding very positively towards it, or people are just giving me like a lot of negative opinions. Then you definitely don't need to feel bad for just being like, okay, I'm done with this today. And that's fine. You need to make sure your mental health is in tip-top shape to do this job, because you are going to be at the mercy of the opinions of literally millions of people, thousands of people, even hundreds of people, which is a lot more people than the average person has to listen to their opinions from on a daily basis. So don't feel bad if you're just feeling overwhelmed one day and you just need to shut down your app. Don't start deleting all your posts and being dramatic every time. You don't be one of them people. But if you need to just close the app for the day and just hang out with your friends, hang out with real life people, then do that. Because you need to remember, the internet is just the internet, baby. People get canceled every day and then they get right back to where they were before. It's not that serious. I know it can feel like the entire world is against you sometimes, when people are just not responding very well to your things, or they're saying mean comments, or they're trying to bully you, or they're disagreeing with all of your opinions. But you're not gonna die. You'll be just fine. You don't know them people, and them people don't know you. So why are you taking their opinions as law? It's not that serious. You also need to remember who has the power in this situation. You have control over the thoughts that you think. You have control over the stuff you post. You literally have control over your comment section. So if there's one specific person who's just going out of their way to do too much, you know you can block them, right? Now, that being said, you're not going to be able to block everybody all the time forever. The more you grow, the less control you'll have over who gets to be in your comments and who does not, because there will just be too many people for you to monitor. And then somebody also might just be making a new account all the time to like bully you. So you can't be like taking it so serious. So you're like, oh my God, I need to like block everybody who ever says anything negative. Oh, I need to make sure that like nobody says anything bad. I need to make sure there's never a hair out of place. There's never anything wrong. I will come on this camera sometimes, lashes flying all up into the air. They could be right now. I don't know. It don't matter. Like sometimes you just gotta be who you are, know who you are internally. Let the internet think whatever they want. You don't know them people. And then people don't know you. So stop taking it so seriously, baby. You have the power in this situation. You control your profile. You control your narrative. And you control your response to everything. So stop responding like a crazy person every time somebody don't agree with you. It's not that serious. Nobody cares. So just vibe. Like, you not just vibing. And I just want you guys to remember that this is just social media. Like, this is not life or death. I know we're trying to build careers. I know we have a passion for what we're doing here, but you don't know these people. These people are not gonna control your pockets unless you do something very out of pocket, which don't do that. Be a good person. But as long as you're putting your heart into this and you're putting out good vibes and good intentions, you cannot fail. Don't let anybody discourage you from doing what you're doing. Don't let anybody try to bag on your post and make you feel bad, because they're gonna have stuff to say. People literally have always had stuff to say. People thought it was so silly I was making little videos and stuff, but now I'm making money from it and I'm working with their favorite brands and I'm getting to fund opportunities and do free things for my friends and my family that I could not do before. And that to me is just so cool. That's what makes it all worthwhile. This is why you just gotta stay 10 toes down, not worry about what anybody says, keep your chest puffed up, keep your heart, anyways, just do you, babe. Just vibe and just know that I got love for y'all. If y'all want to see more content about being an influencer, subscribe. I post social media tips, Instagram tips, and influencer tips. And as always, I am so thankful for my community. Goodbye.